Good morning to everyone. In last video we discussed about concept of controllability as well as concept of observability. In this video we are going to discuss about some problems on concept of controllability. We already know what is controllability and what's the procedure for finding the given system is controllable system or not. Okay, coming to controllability concept, by controlling the input in finite duration of time we can change the initial state of it system to some other desired state. That is nothing but concept of controllability. And coming to procedure, according to Kalman's test we are having two steps. In first step we are going to determine the controllability test matrix, and in second step we are going to determine the determinant of controllability test matrix. If the determinant of controllability test matrix is not equal to 0, then we can conclude that the given system is a controllable system. If the determinant of controllability test matrix is equal to 0, then we can conclude that the given system is not a controllable system. By using those concepts, we are going to determine the given system is controllable or not. Problems on concept of controllability and concept of observability are very simple but very important in gate point of view. Coming to first problem, okay, find the controllability of a system which is described by the state equation. This is our state equation. By using this state equation, we are going to test the given system is controllable or not. That is, the state equation is matrix x1 dot x2 dot is equal to matrix 5 5 0 minus 5, matrix x1 x2 plus matrix 5 0 and u. Here this is the state vector and this matrix is the A, that is nothing but system matrix, and x1 and x2 are the state variables, and this matrix is the input matrix and u is the input. By using this one we are going to test the controllability of a system. This is the given state equation. We are going to compare this given state equation with the standard state equation. That is, by comparing these two equations we are getting matrix A, that is nothing but system matrix A is equal to matrix 5 5 0 minus 5. Similarly, input matrix, that is B, is equal to matrix 5 0. By using Kalman's test we are going to test the given system is controllable or not. According to Kalman's, we are having two steps for finding the given system is controllable or not. That is, in first step we are going to determine the matrix QC, that is nothing but controllability test matrix, by using this formula. Okay, here n represents the number of state variables. After finding this matrix, in second step we are going to determine the determinant of controllability test matrix. If the determinant of controllability test matrix is not equal to 0, then the given system is controllable, otherwise the given system is uncontrollable. By using these two steps we are going to determine the given state equation, that is nothing but given system is controllable or not. The formula for controllability test matrix QC is equal to matrix B, AB, A square B up to so on, A power n minus 1 into B. Here the order of this matrix is depends upon the number of state variables. In our given system, given problem, the number of state variables are 2. So the controllability test matrix is modified like this. That is, in place of n substitute 2. That is, A power 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1. That is, QC is modified as QC is equal to matrix B, AB. Okay, now we are going to determine the AB as well as B. After finding the AB and B, we are going to determine the QC. After finding QC, we are going to determine the determinant of this QC. The determinant of this QC conclude the given system is controllable or not. From the given state equation, we already know the matrix A as well as matrix B. Just to find out AB by using matrix multiplication. That is, this is the matrix A and this is the matrix B. By using matrix multiplication and find out the AB. That is 5 into 5 plus 5 into 0. Similarly, 0 into 5 plus minus 5 into 0. then we are getting 5 into 5 is 25 plus 5 into 0 is 0, that is 25, and 0 into 5 is 0 and minus 5 into 0 is 0, so resultant is 0, and this is the AB. Now we are going to substitute this AB in QC formula. According to number of state variables, the formula for QC is equal to matrix B AB. We already know the matrix B by using the given state equation, and we calculated the AB by using matrix multiplication. Then we are getting this matrix, that is matrix 5, 25, 0, 0. Here this represents the matrix B from the given state equation, and this is the calculated matrix AB. Okay, after finding this one, just to find out the determinant of this QC. The determinant of QC is this one, that is AD minus BC, that is 5 into 0 is 0 minus 0 into 25 is 0. So the resultant is 0. The determinant of controllability test matrix is 0. So we can conclude that given system is a non-controllable system, that is nothing but uncontrollable system. Why? Because the determinant of controllability test matrix is 0, so the given system is uncontrollable system. Okay, this is the procedure for finding the controllability of a given system. That is the one of the model for testing the given system is controllable or not by using Kalman's test of controllability. Coming to second problem, a system is characterized by transfer function. That is, transfer function is given as y of s by u of s is equal to 2 by s cube plus 6 s square plus 11 s plus 6. Then test the controllability of a system. In maximum cases, we will get these type of problems in our exams. Coming to difference between first problem and second problem. In first problem, we directly get the state equation. By using that state equation, we are going to identify the matrix A and matrix B. And by using number of state variables, we are going to identify the order of the controllability test matrix QC. Then by using that one, we can identify the given system is controllable or not. But in this case, we are having the transfer function. By using this transfer function, we are going to determine the or we are going to test the given system is controllable or not. That's the difference between first problem and second problem. Okay, in order to test the controllability of a system, first we require the state equation. So by using this transfer function, we are going to obtain the state equation. In previous videos, we discussed about how to obtain the state equation by using transfer function. By using that procedure, we are going to obtain the state equation by using this transfer function. After obtaining the state equation, we are going to find out the controllability of a system. That is, first consider the transfer function, that is y of s by u of s is equal to 2 by s square plus 6 s square plus 11 s plus 6. Just cross multiply these two. Okay, by cross multiplying, we are getting this one, that is y of s into s square plus 6 s square plus 11 s plus 6, that is equal to 2 into u of s. Okay, just multiply y of s with each factor, then we are getting this equation. Okay, now just apply the inverse Laplace transform to this equation. This is resultant equation. Now we are going to apply the inverse Laplace transform of this resultant equation, that is inverse Laplace transform of s cube into y of s plus 6 s square into y of s plus 11 s into y of s plus 6 into y of s is equal to inverse Laplace transform of 2 into y of s. We know dy by dt can be represented as y dot of t. Okay, by using this formula, we can apply the inverse Laplace transform to this equation, that is s cube into y of s. Inverse Laplace transform s cube into y of s becomes y triple dot of t. Similarly, inverse Laplace transform of s square into y of s becomes y double dot of t. Similarly, for resultant terms, that is 11s into y of s becomes 11 into y of t, y dot of t, and 6 into y of s becomes 6 into y of t, that is equal to 2 into u of t. In this, we are going to consider y of t is equal to x1 of t and y dot of t is equal to x2 of t. Similarly, y double dot of t is equal to x3 of t and y triple dot of t is equal to y x4 of t. By using those things, we are going to obtain the state equation for a given transfer function. This is the resultant equation after applying the inverse Laplace transform. Now let y of t is equal to x1 of t, similarly up to y triple dot of t, that is equal to x4 of t, that is equal to x3 dot of t. Okay, now substitute all those things in this equation, then we are getting this state equation, that is x3 dot of t is equal to this one, that is minus 6 x1 of t minus 11 x2 of t minus 6 x3 of t plus 2 into e of t. And this is the first state equation, this is the second one, and this is the third one. By using these three, we are going to obtain the state equations in matrix form. That is nothing but these are the state equations. Three state equations, we are going to convert these state equations into matrix form. That is matrix x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot is equal to, this is the x1 dot of t, that is 0, 1, 0. And similarly, this is the x2 dot of t, that is 0, 0, 1. And this is the x3 dot of t, that is minus 6, minus 11, minus 6. And these are the three state variables. Plus, we are having only one input for x3 dot of t. So, we are getting 0, 0, 2 and u of t. Now, we are going to compare this state equation with the standard state equation. That is, x dot of t is equal to a into x of t plus b into e of t. Then we are going to obtain the matrix A and matrix B. This is the matrix A and this is the matrix B. This is the state equation by using given transfer function. Now compare this state equation with the standard state equation. By comparing these two, we are getting matrix A is this matrix. Similarly, matrix B is this one. Now by using these two and number of state variables, here number of state variables are 3. By using number of state variables, we are going to find out the order of the controllability test matrix QC. This is the formula for finding the controllability test matrix. Here n represents the number of state variables. Here number of state variables are 3. So this controllability test matrix modified as this one. That is, in place of n, substitute the 3. That is, a power 3 minus 1 is nothing but a square into b. So controllability test matrix QC is equal to matrix b, ab and a square b. Now we have to determine a square b, ab, these two terms. After finding these two terms, we are going to substitute in this matrix. After substituting, we are going to determine the determinant of this QC. Depending upon the determinant of QC, we are going to conclude that the given system is controllable or not. Okay, first we are going to determine the a square. Okay, that is nothing but a into a. Okay, we already know the matrix A and matrix B. Okay, for finding the a square, we require matrix A. So matrix A into matrix A. Just by using matrix multiplication, find out the a square. That is, this is the a square matrix by using the matrix multiplication. After finding the a square, just to find out a square into b, that is a square into b. This is the a square and this is the b which is obtained from the state equation, that is 0, 0, 2. Okay, just by using matrix multiplication, find out a square into b, that is 0 into 0, 0 into 0 plus 1 into 2, that is 2. Similarly, minus 6 into 0 plus minus 11 into 0 plus minus 6 into 2, we are getting minus 12. Similarly, 36 into 0 plus 60 into 0 plus 25 into 2, we are getting 50. Okay, this matrix is the A square B. Similarly, find out the matrix AB, that is multiplication of matrix A and matrix B. We already know these two matrices, and substitute and by using matrix multiplication find out the result of AB. Okay, that is 0 into 0 plus 1 into 0 plus 0 into 2, that is 0. Similarly, 0 into 0 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 2, that is 2. Similarly, minus 6 into 0 plus minus 11 into 0 plus minus 6 into 2. So we are getting minus 12. This is the matrix AB. After finding A square B, AB, substitute these two values in QC. Okay, by substituting these two values in QC, we are getting QC is equal to this one. Okay, this represents the matrix B and this represents the result of AB, and similarly this represents the A square into B. Now we have to determine the determinant of this QC. This is the resultant matrix of QC. Now we have to determine the determinant of this matrix. I think everyone know how to determine the determinant of 3 by 3 matrix. That is, matrix QC is equal to, first consider this element. Okay, by considering this element, we have to eliminate this column and this row, and we have to determine the determinant of remaining two rows, that is these two, that is 2 into 50 minus 12 into minus 12. We are nothing but this one. Similarly, consider this element. By considering this element, we have to eliminate this column and this row, and we have to identify the determinant of remaining four elements, that is nothing but this one. Similarly, consider this element. By considering this element, we have to eliminate this row and this column and determine the determinant of these four elements. Then we are getting this one. Finally, we are getting the determinant of QC is minus 8. That is nothing but the determinant of controllability test matrix is not equal to 0. So the given system is controllable system. These type of problems are very important in exam point of view. Try to practice these type of problems. Up to now in this video, we discussed about problems on controllability. That is, testing the controllability of a system if the system having the state equation and the system having the transfer function. In the coming video, we are going to discuss about problems on concept of observability. Thank you.